Good afternoon, Magnoliaites. Today is a special Tuesday broadcast. I am Mr. Loper, and this is Hey, What's Going On? Your weekly announcements. Today's national holiday is the birthday of the American Navy, so happy birthday, Navy. Fun fact of the day, the American Navy was actually disbanded right after the American Revolution. We figured, all right, we won, we did a pretty good job, we're done for now. It wasn't until the Naval Act of 1794 that a permanent American Navy was formed when merchant ships kept getting attacked and America was like, all right, we should do something about this. As for birthdays, not just the Navy, but we actually have a few this week. Over the weekend, on the 10th, was Mr. Sorrentino's birthday, our esteemed principal. Today is yours truly's birthday. I, Mr. Loper, have my own birthday today, and I am turning 326. And tomorrow, October 14th, is our very own Mr. G's birthday. Happy birthday to all of us, gentlemen. Important upcoming events. Thursday starts Gold Groups returning to school. So if that's you, we look forward to seeing you, our friends. We've already been seeing Blue Group for the last 2 days, and it's nice to see people in person again. So again, looking forward to having you around. As for soccer, today is an away game for the soccer team at Gibbsboro, and on Thursday, they are away at Stratford. Good luck, Mustangs. Show them who's boss. And now, for my favorite segment, puns. All right, what is the musical part of a snake? The scales. Why did the pianist bang his head against the keys? He was playing by ear. And lastly, what did Jay-Z call his wife before they got married? Fiance. All right, on to Mr. Carpenter and Mr. Johnson with their sports corner. I'll see you later.
Mr. Johnson here.
And this is our weekly edition of Sports Corner. Just wanted to kind of recap what happened last week. I had a pretty good week. I was undefeated in all my picks. So I won all four of my games, including the Monday night game last night, which was kind of a nail biter, but New Orleans Saints was able to pull it out with a
4-0, 3-1, right?
Yeah.
All right.
So 3-1. So we're caught up. We are exactly tied. So our record right now stands at, looking at the screen over here, 12-3-1. So I have 12 wins, 3 losses, 1 tie. And we have, Mr. Johnson has 12 wins, 3 losses, and 1 tie. So we'll see what happens this week. Let's get to our, this week's picks. I'm picking Baltimore. So we're going head-to-head. Okay, I think Baltimore is going to continue to roll the Philadelphia Eagles. I just don't think the Eagles will be able to win this game this week. I bet on them before and it got me in trouble, so I'm not going to make that mistake again. However, Mr. Johnson,
I think the Eagles are going to win. I'm going on a limb here. I think they're going to win because it was such a close game. They started to look a little better last week, so we'll see.
I hope you're right.
Taking a chance here.
Sooner or later, yeah. You're going to win a game. All right, so with that said, all right, so we're picking head-to-head there, so that's where we differ. So I think Baltimore's going to win. You take Philly. I'm taking the Tennessee Titans. I think they're looking strong. They're going to win. I'm also going to continue to roll with Kansas City. I've had good luck with them, so I'm picking them again.
I'm also taking the Chiefs there, too, yeah. As well. So.
Yeah, so your last two picks, Kansas City and L.A. Chargers.
Yep. Right?
You're taking those two. So we both believe that those two are the same pick. So our only matchup head-to-head this week is Philly-Baltimore.
Mm-hmm.
And you picked Indianapolis Colts, right?
I did. I think the Colts are going to beat the Bengals. They just look pretty bad this year. So I'm going to stick with them losing. They're going to be on a little losing streak here. So
really, it comes down to what happens with the Philadelphia game. That's really
that's our tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So that's Magnolia Sports Corner.
All right. Till next time, guys. We'll see you.
See you next week.
And that was Mr. Johnson and Mr. Carpenter with Sports Corner. And now on to Ms. Arkema with some smart facts.
It's Miss Arkema with your weekly Smart Facts. This week I am introducing you to another October-born artist, Roy Lichtenstein. We'll get to these dots later. Roy Lichtenstein was a founder of the pop art movement. This was a style of art that used popular images, from everyday items like Campbell's soup cans to popular movie stars of the time like Marilyn Monroe. Lichtenstein's artwork was heavily influenced by comic book illustrations like Wonder Woman and Superman. His artwork was characterized by a style called, a technique called Benday dots, which are very small dots that are placed very close together. Back then, this was a way to achieve shading and the secondary colors. His very first artwork to showcase this technique is called Look, Mickey. Lichtenstein was inspired to create this painting when his son said, "Hey, Dad, I bet you can't paint as good as that." While Lichtenstein is well known in the world of art, he is criticized by some as being a copyist by simply taking the artwork of others and making small changes to make them his own. Here we see a painting done by Picasso, and a not so different one here done by Lichtenstein using those Benday dots. Regardless of your opinion, one thing is for sure. Lichtenstein loved art. He painted 10 hours a day up to the age of 73, and he also taught at Rutgers University right here in New Jersey. And those are your weekly smart facts. I look forward to seeing you next week.
And that was Miss Arkema with some smart facts. And now on to our very special guest, Mrs. DeVekis, with some Monday motivation. Although it is Tuesday, but we won't tell. All right, see you in a few.
I'm Mrs. DeVekis, one of the school counselors here, and I want to leave you with a little morning motivation. The secret to getting ahead is getting started. So don't procrastinate, get your work done, and if you're stuck on something or need help, don't hesitate to reach out to your teachers or one of your school counselors. And if you need me throughout the week, you can email me at jdevekis@magnoliaschools.org. I look forward to hearing from you. And have a wonderful week.
And that about wraps us up for another Hey, What's Going On? We hope you guys have an excellent week going forward, and we hope to see you soon. All right, make it a good one.